this evening's concert. And in the past 2 days, today and yesterday, and tomorrow, we have 3 days conference and basically to view the guqin music in the 21st century. And last night, we had wonderful concert by our students, and it's all some of the ancient guqin music and some of the contemporary pieces. It was a wonderful concert. And today, we have a whole day discussion. There are endless topics about the guqin. And because the guqin is a very ancient instrument, back to at least 3,000 years. And so there are lots of history, lots of story related with guqin, related with the guqin's repertoire. So, and then today we have what I call, here it's called Zhao Xiaoxia and the trio of three continents in concerts. But on the other word, I will call it's a really a true master's concert. You will hear four masters. Zhao Xiaoxia, Professor Zhao Xiaoxia is from the Central Conservatory of Music, and she just came for this conference, and so she will play four pieces for the first half of the concert. And then the second half of the concert, we're so fortunate to have the trio of three continents to join us. And those three masters, it's on tour around the Northeast America, and we're fortunate to have them. And Gao Hong is a really dear friend, and she played the Chinese Pipa, and last October she joined me with the Orchestra Now. We did a Chinese New Year concert in Bar and New York City. And then now she bring another two of her friends, one from Venezuela, and he's going to play the Venezuelan harp. And another friend, also her friend from Syria, and he's going to play Syrian oud. So you can see that's really, it's like a world apart, but they play together. And in the second half, they also join with Chinese guqin, with Professor Zhao Xiaoxia, to play another jam together. So it's going to be really interesting and I think an exciting concert. Especially many of those playings are improvising. You know, so you can see how the great masters can really play together, take the moment, and how they can interact with each other and produce great music. So that's it's tonight's program. And the conference in general is a once-year project that the U.S.-China Music Institute has been producing in the past 5 years. Even during the pandemic years, we did online as well. And each year, we focus on different topic, and we have a scholarly discussion. We also have performance to accompany with the academic discussion. So, and I really thank you so much for supporting our Bard College, supporting the conservatory, and supporting the U.S.-China Music Institute. And so please enjoy the concert. Now, let me introduce our great soloist, Professor Zhao Xiaoxia. Since the piece is not on the program, so I will just say a few words about each piece that she's played before she played. And for some people don't know the instrument, this is called guqin. And or you just call qin, or you know, in the old days it's called qin. It's the oldest Chinese instrument throughout Chinese history. And as a matter of fact, because the qin, and all the instruments after that have to name something qin. So for example, piano in Chinese called guqin, it means metal qin. And violin is called xiaoqin, means a little carrying qin. And cello is called daqin, means big carrying qin. Yeah, you can see the qin, see how important qin in Chinese history. Basically, the word qin is just equal to music itself. So that's how important it is. Okay, so so the first piece we play called Liu Shui, flowing water. And flowing water, this is there's a story, come visit. The story back to what you call spring-autumn period, which is 3,000 years ago, and in the ancient China, and there is a very famous qin player, Yu Boya, So this Yu Boya, he played the qin just flawlessly, but he just, you know, frustrated, nobody really understand. So in the end, he just went to the mountains. He played in the mountain just for himself. And then one day, there is a carpenter, his name is Ziqi, yeah. So Ziqi came by and listened to him play. Then after he played, Ziqi said, oh, that you just played, it's about a mountain. Then he said, wow, this guy know what I'm playing. Then he played another piece, and he said, oh, that is flowing water. So from there on, they become best friends. Then still some years later, Ziqi died of disease. And then Boya just smashed his chin. He said, my best friend, only one understand my music, that I'm not going to play the qin anymore. So that is the story followed with that piece. And another interesting thing is that today, I just see a video, you know, flowing around. It's about a French president visiting China. Macron is visiting Beijing. And he and Xi Jinping invite him for dinner. So the video is in beginning of the dinner, and there's a qin player playing Liu Shui, playing the flowing water. Then Xi Jinping starts to introduce to Macron, so this piece is what it's about. And so the guqin players are her friend. And but suppose she should play for Macron and Xi Jinping, but because she's here, then she fled her friend had to go there to play. Yeah, you can see. So that's the first piece, flowing water. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
the piece is not too hard, what do you call, not too strong, not too soft, not too fast, not too slow. It's everything is a moderate speed. And Yi Dong, actually, she composed a piece herself. I translate it as called easygoing. It's an improvisation piece. Everything is improvised. All right, Yi Dong.
Thank you.
So you can play for us. The name, the title is called Li Sao. I think some our Chinese friends already understand what that means. And, but the score first appeared in Ming Dynasty, which is around the 15th century. It's called the secret score of Qin. Sao is written after a poem. It's called Li Sao. Li Sao is really a poem composed by a great poet from warrior time, warrior state time, which is 3,000 years before now, and by Qiyuan. So let me say this again. The piece is after a poetry of Qiyuan's Li Sao, but composed in late Tang Dynasty and appeared in the Ming Dynasty's school. So now please enjoy Li Sao.
Thank you.
actually, there's a story behind it. I didn't want to tell you beforehand, you know, just to experience music. Basically, the story about this piece is about also from a warrior state period, 2,500 years ago. There are many kingdoms fighting each other. And this guy, his father, was executed by the emperor of Hangu. And then the son decided on to have a revenge. What he did, he went to the mountains. He played qin. He became the best qin player anywhere. And when the emperor of the Han heard that there's a wonderful qin player, then the emperor invited him to his palace to play for him. Then he took the opportunity to kill the emperor and killed himself. That's the story. But the piece actually it's basically a kind of a pay tribute to this Nizhong about his bravery and his heroism. Yeah, so thank you so much. Thank you. Trio of three conductors to have their part in our concert, and I think in one of the pieces they will play with Professor Zhao Xiaoxia again. Okay, enjoy the concert. Thank you. Intermission.
thank you so, so much for having us, Professor Tai and Catherine and Xiaofang Laoshi, Kat and Mark, everybody. I just feel like so honored to be here. Here's three of us. As everybody knows, our music is never written down. Everything lives on the spot. You're part of the process. So we don't know, you don't know, nobody knows what the music would be. So let's hear from the heart. So our music is not from China, not from Syria, not from Venezuela. It's called music, new world music. So they're still working on that. So since they're still working on that, so our original tour supposed to be with Venezuela, three continents, from South America, then China, Asia, then other one is from Africa, West Africa. But the visa, unfortunately, yesterday just got it, so we delayed it. So before I left the tour, I called my long collaborator, Issam Rafea, on the phone in the early morning. He knew I never call early morning. The first thing he called me, and he heard me call, "Are you okay?" I said, "Not okay," because I need you come with me tomorrow. Okay, that's what he is here. So. These two just met. Me and the harpist met last August. So we just met, actually that's the second time. How we met is a really fascinating story. I always fascinated about the kora. So my daughter's in London, so I want to learn kora. So I asked the Nexus World Music label, say if you could introduce me a kora player. So they said, great, well, since you like to improvise, how about we reserve a 5-hour studio? Just go have a CD. So we even haven't met yet, so we already had a CD commissioned. Then, after we talk, he said, we're going to see this amazing harpist. When he said amazing, I said, I really want to see how amazing it is. So I went there. And I really, really enjoy. So I hope you enjoy his music too. And Issam Rafea from Syria. We've been together, we met at Carlton. I've been teaching at Carlton for 22 years. So he came as a guest artist. Then before he left, I said, how about I go to a studio? Then we had a CD. So here we are. Are we still not there yet? Oh, I heard that.
Can you hear? You can hear?
I said, we never know what the music is. Not Chinese, not Syrian. So now I would like to introduce my friend on the left. He's come from Venezuela, and he invented this harp. And the traditional Venezuela music has this harp, but he invented to have a 37, because they usually have three music together, so that's why he's a loop. But tonight, because we only have three perform, so we couldn't do a long solo, but I will let him to do a short, very short, it's called demonstration.
Thank you.
Then we'll go to his solo, then we'll go to his country. But because we didn't have the time, so we just kind of went into a country because they take the country come in, we go in as our third foreigner to observe how we see their country. So now let's go to the Middle East to see the oud. Oud is about 5,000 years old. Actually, Pipa, I was joking, the Pipa is there. The oud is the grandpa of the pipa, because we start with the barbar, then 5,000 years later, the oud went to west world, become a lute and a guitar, went to east, sitar, pipa. So now we're actually a family. So now let's go to his country. He would take us go to the Middle East Arabic music. Because we have next to is China, so I'm not leading for anything for China. So we'll just go to Venezuela, South America. Now we go to Middle East.
Syria. Thank you.
doing us.
I got to tell you, tonight, you're witness the first in the world. First of all, we already have three different people. Now the guqin, usually in the ancient guqin now, and we're doing with the unbelievable, incredible Professor Zhao to join us. I think it will be very interesting. Again, it's free improvisation. I always say, for everything the world premiere and never can be repeated. So now to listen to guqin, oud, and pipa, and Venezuela electronic harp.
Thank you.
we have a delightful evening. Now let's go to China.
Thank you.